Coming up in this Brightline construction update, this is the seventh update in my series looking at the bridge construction progress in southern Brevard County, Florida. In this update, we'll look at the bridges at the Sebastian River, Turkey Creek, Crane Creek, and the Eau Gallie River. We'll start in Roseland at the Sebastian River Bridge. Work continues here on demolishing the unused side of the existing bridge and beginning to install the first side of the new double track bridge. At the north end of the bridge, beams for the first four spans have been installed. Unlike Crane Creek, which is being built with metal beams, this bridge is being built with concrete ones. The two cranes are both working south, installing the new pilings and piers while also demolishing parts of the old bridge. They're about halfway across the river now. It appears three more piers are ready to have beams installed, and a fourth is close to having its bend cap completed. Pilings are five additional piers are in various states of installation. A new addition to this temporary work trestle is this bump out, which they look to be using to store different parts and equipment out of the way of the crane's path. Here's a closer look at the cranes and what they are currently working on. And flying north along the bridge. here's a general overview of the bridge. At over a third of a mile long, this is the largest bridge being built as part of this project. Next up is Turkey Creek and Palm Bay. It looks like the temporary trestle is complete and work is shifting to the new bridge here. The first pilings have been installed. Here's an overview looking east. There's a public boat ramp next to the bridge, making this one of the easiest bridges to view safely from the ground. Crews have been removing ties from the unused side of the bridge. Here's an overview looking west. This is the first piling in the water. Looking south, you can see Port Malabar Boulevard in the distance. Another piling has been installed here near the abutment. And here's an engineer's eye view going across in both directions. Our next stop is Crane Creek in downtown Melbourne. Here, crews are continuing the process of removing the temporary trestle from the side of the bridge now that the spans here on the north end are complete. The parts are being staged on the west side of the existing bridge to be reused when the temporary trestle is rebuilt on that side. The beams are laying on the unused spans, and the pilings have been placed parallel to the bridge so that it will be out of the way as the new work trestle is being built. This side of the bank has been built up for the temporary trestle to be built from. The trestle has to be rebuilt on this side as the current one is in the way of where the last part of the new bridge has to be built. From here, the future view of the bridge is starting to be revealed. Our last stop is the Eau Gallie River, a few miles north. Here, work on the temporary trestle looks to be complete, and crews have moved on to installing pilings. This was the test piling they did several months ago before finishing the temporary trestle. This piling is the new addition. Here's an overview looking west. And looking east. They are using the small barge to move equipment around and to provide access closer to the water. They have removed more ties from the unused side of the bridge. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.